community manager here at That Said, and today I'm in the kitchen to make a brownie trifle. This recipe was submitted by Whitney Copeland, our user from Mississippi, who won the August Brewmaster Contest, and it just looked so good that we couldn't stand to see it. We had to actually make it for ourselves, so here we go.
Now once there lived an old man with a very crooked nose. Lived in log hut and they call him Old Man Mose.
Yeah.
The first step is to make a batch of brownies. If you're ambitious, you can make them from scratch, but if you're like me, you can just make it from a mix at the store. First, turn on the oven to preheat while you mix up your brownie ingredients. Then dump the mix into a medium large bowl.
I'm telling you, I believe.
Next, you want to add the additional ingredients to complete the mix. Mine requires butter and milk.
Mose kicked the bucket. Mose kicked the bucket. Mose kicked the bucket. Mose kicked the bucket.
Mose kicked. Now, before we finish the mix, we have to add a special ingredient because this is a brownie trifle, and that is a teaspoon of instant coffee dry crystals.
I saw an old man laying flat on his back.
So now you're almost ready to bake the brownies, but first you need to grease the bottom and sides of the pan so that it comes out easily.
I ain't gonna do that no more.
So you can go ahead and pour it all in. Just have to make sure to get it evenly spread around so that it cooks evenly when it's in the oven.
Telling you, I found out what it's all.
So by now, the oven should be nice and warm, and we're just going to add the brownies in so they can cook for a little while.
Most keep the bucket.
The brownie's done, so now we're going to take it out of the oven and leave it on top to cool for a little while. And now while the brownie's cooling, we're going to make the pudding to go on top of it. We start out by pouring the milk into the bowl, and then we'll add the instant pudding mix. We're going to beat this together as we pour it until it becomes smooth. And now we get to the fun part, assembling the trifle. First we start out by cutting up the brownie. We're going to cut it into 1-inch squares, approximately. Now I'm going to place half of our 1-inch square brownies into a 3-quart glass bowl. And you need to make sure that it's glass so that you can see all of the yummy dessert that's going to go inside. The next step is to pour half of the pudding on top of the brownies. Take the toffee bits and you're going to sprinkle them on top of the pudding. And on top of the toffee bits, you're going to spread about one layer of whipped cream, about a cup and a half. Now we're going to repeat the same layers again with the brownies, the pudding, toffee bits, and whipped cream.
Give me a single sound, I ain't going to do it no more, because I believe,
oh man,
I believe,
oh man,
I believe,
oh man,
that old man Mose is dead. I'm telling you, I believe,
oh man,
I believe.
It looks lovely. Now before you eat it, you just have to put it in the fridge for about 4 hours before you serve it, and then it'll be ready to enjoy. Now it's time to enjoy the fruits of our labor. So we're here with the rest of the That Said team, ready to dive in. So just pull your piece of edible art out of the fridge, get it with your friends, and dive in.
Right now, Mose kick the bucket. Mose kick the bucket. Mose kick the bucket. Mose kick the bucket. Mose kick the bucket.
If you think you can make a brownie trifle better than ours, or if you want to give Whitney's recipe a shot, just send us a video of you making it and we'll feature you on our blog.